Mike has asked, how do you decide where to locate the ring gap for each ring? Okay, so this is actually a pretty common question, a little bit of misunderstanding around this. While yes, it is important to locate the rings accurately when we are building the engine, just as a matter of course, it's basically best practice for engine building. The idea behind it for our compression rings, for example, we want to locate the ring gaps 180 degrees opposed. So there isn't essentially a straight shot for our blow-by gases to go straight past the two ring gaps. Now, the information from JE will actually give you, or your ring manufacturer will actually give you that specification. We'll just jump to our overhead shot here and I'll just show you this. Maybe a little bit hard to see the details on this, but essentially we've got our piston and it shows us our top compression ring, our second compression ring, our top oil gap ring, and our bottom oil gap ring as well. So basically that's how we're going to align everything when we get started. However, the bit that most people miss is that the rings don't actually stay stationary. They will actually rotate on the piston in operation. So what we're going to go through there as a best practice when we're building our engine, they're not going to stay there anyway. That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.